and also I keep my office hours the rest of the semester and also the rest of reading period, but especially before the project is due on December 4th, I will always be available for questions. And you feel free also to email me questions, and if you have a project already kind of submitted early, you can maybe get already some feedback. If you submit a project at the last moment, of course, there is no possibility anymore to get feedback on time. The project is on the website and on the course website, and the questions are at the very end. And it's due on December 4th. So this is very strict. I want to make this sure. There's absolutely no extension. It is a deadline. And if it doesn't come on December 4th midnight with a timestamp of September, December 4th, then I'm not counting it. And it's electronic by mail, so you send it with an attachment by regular mail, and I grade it. So this is my trait. I love to do that and see all this creativity. And then I usually make a gallery of projects. In the past we have done, this was for a couple of years, we were even able to print some. You are welcome to work together, and also welcome to ask me or ask others about things or look things up on the web. But it's always important that you submit your own work, and also important is that you give credit to sources if you just use external sources. There's possibilities to scan things. This is a scanner here, which actually kind of just scans objects. But it's easy. This is the frog in our garden, which I once scanned, and this is the frog here in 3D. I actually got some nice models recently of Mickey and his friends, and I scanned Mickey here and put. Move on. First of all, save things frequently, and then start with a new notebook. We will just do that afterwards. It's nice if you can kind of tune the parameters or look up how to tune the parameters. Also make backups. This is related to save frequently, but what is actually important is that you have also all the versions, and that's always when you are doing some computer, something related with computers. If something is kind of screwing up and your file is rotten, even if you have a backup, the rotten part is also in the backup. So you want to have older backups, so that you don't have wasted a couple of hours or days. Sometimes in programming, you have weeks or years of work can go. Use this also to socialize a little bit, and if you have trouble doing this, just get started with somebody else. Again, network is fine, but you have to submit your own project. So saving frequently is because of Murphy's law. And Murphy was an optimist. Everything which can go wrong will go wrong. And these were real footage of people who actually have lost some data. And you can really be mad. So there's a Chinese saying which says, ask and be a fool for a moment, don't ask and be a fool for the rest of your life. Absolute deadline. This is the deadline, and you have to catch that deadline. And that's one of the things which I think is a very important skill, that you can beat deadlines, even if it's not the perfect project, but you want to submit it. And one of the other things which I want to stress is originality. So it's a very important trait to be original, and it's surprisingly hard. I definitely don't want to see things like a snowman. You know, I actually kind of I don't know how many snowmen I got submitted, because it's so easy to do, and I don't know, they all look the same. There are three spheres on top of each other. There is a hat and there is a cone as a nose. It's almost the same snowman. And that's not original. Each problem is pass-fail. Pass-fail is kind of comes up in that movie Sahara.
It's not a district court, really.
Kind of pass-fail, which I always thought was easier.
You can do that. I actually can tell you how to, or can help you with that. So there are apps, for example, these guys here, I actually just, there's an app, and then you just make a couple of photos around it, and it submits, and then it gets it back. And, project is on that lab page. You can download it, you click here, and then usually when you have Mathematica installed, it already opens it, and that's the whole project. I urge you to start pretty quickly with the project. So let's say here, this is my my project, Oliver project, my 21A project, 2000. The first problem is that one point is find the area of a region which is given here. Area, and yes.
How do you make like the different 3,000 spaces?
Oh, that's good. I'm glad you asked this. So first of all, I got the title by just copy paste. So I want to make then a second title. I take this, I copy and I paste this. Now, in order to start a new cell, go somewhere such that the cursor is flat. You see the cursor is now flat, then click and type return. Then you can just open a new cell. And by default, that new cell is a cell where you can calculate. So this is problem one. So I forgot something very important. What did I forget?
Save.
This is problem two. Let me just show you an example how you integrate, right? That's how Mathematica does integration. And you can also do integration over infinite, improper intervals, but any integrate will give you a number. So this is problem three, and this is a parametric plot of a surface. So for example, u squared plus v squared. You could actually submit that to a printer, and it would print it. And this looks maybe like a nice surface. It could be a rocket, right? But it doesn't actually, this would not qualify for a solution here. Absolutely not. So the options of that thing, of that graphics, tells you everything which is kind of has been defined. What is important is the viewpoint and the view vertical. I copy paste that in here. I can copy paste that in here. And whenever I'm actually running this, I will always see it from that angle. So this is the viewpoint from where you see it, and the vertical is what is up in that world. I urge you to try to make something which is unique a little bit, which you can claim to be your surface. This looks a little bit like a toilet. Or maybe it looks like a heart, actually, kind of. We can bend it to make something more, yeah. But maybe something like a heart, so whatever you have an idea. Maybe give it a name also. So we have already done problem three. Does it make sense? Kind of, this is problem three is about the parametric surface. It also gets you a little bit, explore a little bit these parametric surfaces while you are at it. Then you can already review parametric surfaces for the final exam. Now, the next thing is to find a 3D region plot of your choice. So let's just start here. Oh, I forgot something. What did I forget?
Save it.
Because you can do all kinds of things. For example, you can say, okay, I want also to have maybe y squared plus c squared bigger than 1. That's not good. Maybe 0.1. I actually drill a hole, 0.3. I drill a hole into that. So now I have a hyperboloid in a hole. And again, it looks a little bit jaggy, right? So it's not yet, so we could actually say plot points, maybe 50. So we make it finer. You intersect it with another hyperboloid and see what is actually happening. Oh, that's actually pretty cool. I like that. Surface, so this is my problem five. Yeah, I have to move on a little bit.